Hello dear friends, in this video we will discuss about the ordinary differential equation of first order and first degree. So general form of first order and first degree ordinary differential equation can be written as f of x 1 divided by dx is equal 0. Divided by dx has order 1, therefore this generalized form will be what? First order and first degree. Also, it can be written as explicit form divided by dx is equal f of xy. Also, it can be written as m of xy dx plus n of xy dy is equal 0. Now, we talk about the solution of the differential equation can be obtained by using the various methods. So classifying them as follow. So first we have to classify. So is the differential equation, is the variable separable? That means we can separate the variable, then we can apply the variable separable. Then we will talk about the homogeneous differential equation. That means if the differential equation is homogeneous, then we have the another matter. Then we have the exact differential equation, non-exact, linear differential equation, and the non-linear differential equation, and that is known as Bernoulli's form, or you can say Bernoulli's differential equation. And all these we will discuss in this chapter. So let us first understand that what is the variable separable. So if I consider the general form, that is dy by dx is equal mx, m of x into n of y. That means this can be written as mx, m of x dx plus n of y dy is equal 0, and this is called a differential equation with the variable separable. That means here you can observe this is the function of x and this is the function of y. That means we can have the separate form, that we can do the integration with respect to x as well as we can do integration with respect to y. So now we are going to integrating of the equation number 1, we get this one. And after integrating constant c is there, so whatever we solve this form, and that will be what exactly our required answer. So let us understand the first question. Solve 9y y dash plus 4x is equal 0. So this can be written as 9y dy by dx plus 4x is equal 0. So from this you may write 9 times dy plus 4 times x dx is equal 0, that you can, and this is the only function of y and this is the function of x. Now we can integrate it. So what it will be, so 9 times y dy plus 4 times x dx, and integrating constant is nothing but c. So after integrating you will get y square by 2, and this is the 4 times x square by 2 is equal c. So this is what, 9 times y square plus this is the 2 y square is equal c, and this is what exactly required general solution, that is required general solution. Why it is known as the general solution? Because there is only one constant and the differential equation has the order is nothing but 1, and therefore it is known as a general solution. Now we have another question, that is the dy by dx is equal to e raised to x minus y plus x square into e raised to minus 1. So solve this question. So first let us understand it can be separable or not. So for that here we have that the e raised to minus x minus 1, this can be written as e raised to x into e raised to minus y plus x square e raised to minus 1. Now you can take e raised to minus y common, so you will have e raised to x plus x square. This is what dy by dx. Now you can understand that the e raised to y can be written as on the left hand side, so it will be e raised to y, and here we can write that the e raised to x plus x square dx. Now it is required to integrating with respect to whatever it is, so integrating it. So we have e raised to y dy is equal integration e raised to x plus x square dx plus integrating constant c is there. So integration of the exponential function is nothing but e raised to y, it's itself, and here we have e raised to x, and this is the x raised to cube divided by 3 plus arbitrary constant that is c, and this is known as what exactly? General solution, which is general solution. But if I modify this question with y of 0 is equal, that is 0, and therefore this problem is going to be solved initial value problem. So in that case, how we can solve? So in that case, we can mention that given y of 0 is equal, that is 0. That means, what does it mean by this one? When x is equal 0, then the values of y is nothing but 0. And therefore, by 1, what we can write? So by 1, so it is clear that e raised to 0, then e raised to 0, x is equal 0, plus c is there. So we can say this is the 1 plus c. So from this, we can say c is equal 0. And therefore, we can have the equation number 1 reduces to e raised to y is equal e raised to x plus x square by 3. And this is what exactly particular solution. This is particular solution because it is obtained from the general solution by giving particular value to the arbitrary constant, and therefore it is known as particular solution. So this is the nice one question, dy by dx minus y is equal y square. So that also can be written as y square. Just take this y on the right hand side. So we have dy by dx is equal y square plus y. So we can write this way. Now it is very easy because we can separate out. So dy divided by y into y plus 1 is equal dx. So also on the left hand side, whatever it is, according to that, we can simplify as the numerator y plus 1 minus y divided by y times y plus 1. And now we do the difference and separate division. So what it will be? So 1 divided by y minus 1 divided by y plus 1 dy is equal to dx. Now you can do integrating with respect to y on the left hand side, and on the right hand side integration with respect to x, and integrating constant c is there. So finally you will get ln y minus ln y plus 1 is equal x plus c. And we know that the standard form, that ln a minus ln b, that can be written as ln a by b. And using that rule, we have that is ln mod of y divided by y plus 1 is equal x plus c. But whenever we take the exponential function, so what we can write? This is general solution, or you can extend this form to the next form. Removing the ln, that means we are taking the exponential on the both the side. So we will have y divided by y plus 1 is equal e raised to x plus c. But this also can be read e raised to x into e raised to c. And e raised to c is nothing but arbitrary constant. So a times e raised to x, and that is what? Our y divided by y plus 1. And that is going to be final answer, where a is nothing but e raised to c, that arbitrary constant 1 is there, order is 1, therefore this is a general solution. Next, the homogeneous differential equation. So let us first understand what do you mean by homogeneous equation. So this is the general form, dy by dx is equal m of xy divided by n of xy. This form also can be written as m of xy dx plus n of xy dy is equal 0. And this differential equation is homogeneous if the m of xy and n of xy is homogeneous functions of the same degree. If m of xy is the degree 2, then n of xy must have the degree 2. If m of xy is the degree 2 and n of xy is the degree 3, then it is not going to be the homogeneous. That's why it is mentioned over here that the same degree. So let us understand with the example. But if you talk about that this form, then how we can? So think about that. If m of xy is the degree that is 2, again denominator has the degree 2, because same degree, then what we can have? That is the answer is nothing but 1. That means this can be written as what? X raised to 0. That means it will be what? 0 degree. So what we can conclude, whenever we write as this form and m divided by n and it has the only 0 degree, then it is going to be what? Homogeneous. Let us understand this question number 1. x times x square minus y square dx plus x raised to cube. So first, let us understand with this concept, and then after we will talk about this one form. So m of x y will be x times x square minus y square, and n of x y is equal, that is the y raised to cube. Now, to check the homogeneous function of the same degree, we take m of dx dy and then n of dx dy. That means x is replaced by dx, y is replaced by dy. So we have m of xy is equal, this is x, into x square minus y square. So x is replaced by dx, y is replaced by, that is dy. And after simplifying, what we can say, one t is there, and this will be the t square. So t square into that will be t raised to cube, and the remaining is what exactly m of xy. So we have obtained the common degrees for, that is the t raised to cube, only three, that has a function t raised to cube. Again, n tx ty, that can be written as, because n x y is nothing but y raised to cube, and according to that we can write this, and therefore n of tx dy will be t raised to cube n of x y. So both have the same degree, and therefore the given differential equation is what exactly homogeneous. But if we talk about the m of x y divided by n of x y, and this is the same as what dy by dx. But m of x y is what, x into x square minus y square divided by y raised to cube. So numerator has the degree is what, if I talk about the numerator has the degree is what, 3, both the term has. So we can say degree is nothing but 3, and same that for the denominator has the degree is what, 3, and therefore 1, and therefore we can say this is what, x raised to 0, or you can say y raised to 0, or you can say t raised to 0. Because anything power raised to power is 0, that it will be 1. That means we can say 0 degree is there, and therefore we can say this, the given differential equation is nothing but homogeneous. So whether it is homogeneous function, then we can solve it. But what we have to do? So let us understand the method. To solve the homogeneous differential equation, whether it is of the form this one or if it is of the form this one, step number one, letting y is equal vx, then we have to differentiate on the both the side with respect to x. So dy by dx is equal v plus x times dv by dx. Only we have done that differentiation with respect to x. Now substituting dy by dx in the equation number one, but I'm just going to consider equation number one is this one. So what I will have, v plus x times dv by dx is equal, this is the n x, but y is replaced by vx, and n of x, y is replaced by vx. And this is what you can observe, that only it will be the function of y, only will be v, because x will be the element. So if I said this function is nothing but g of v, so what I will have, x times dv by dx is equal g of v minus v. And now it is very easy to apply that the variable separable method, and after that we can solve final answer. So let us understand the first question. X square y dx minus x raised to cube plus x y square dy is equal 0. From equation, it is very easy to say that this differential equation is nothing but homogeneous. Homogeneous, that means simply we will understand each term has the same degree. So first term has the degree 2 plus 1, so it is going to be 3, again 3, again 3. Therefore, we can say this differential equation is nothing but homogeneous. In other words, you can write dy by dx. Dy by dx, that means I'm just going to write the dx by here, and this on the left hand side, so we will have this one. But from this it is clear that x can be common and it can be cancelled out. So we have x y divided by x square plus y square. The numerator is nothing but m of x y, and the denominator is the n of x y. So now also it is very easy, because the numerator has the degree 2, denominator has the degree 2, so it is going to be what, exactly 1. That means both have the same degree. And therefore, we can say that the given differential equation can be solved by the homogeneous method. So according to the method, first we will take that the y is equal to v of x. Now just we take the differentiating on the both the side with respect to x. So dy by dx is equal to v plus x times dv by dx. Now substituting this value in this equation, so dy by dx, that is what v times plus x dv by dx is equal, x square is there, y can be written as vx, also y can be written as, that is the vx, so we will have this one. So after simplifying, what you will get, x times x square v divided by x square plus v square x square. Now it is very easy that x square can be taken and get cancelled out. So only what we will have, v divided by 1 plus v square, this is only function of v. So that already I have written that v plus x times dv by dx is equal to v divided by 1 plus v. Now you can take this on the right hand side, so you will have this one after taking the LCM. So this will be multiplied here and you will have this one, and simplifying you will get minus v square divided by 1 plus v on the left hand side, x times dv by dx. Now you can make the separate, because variable separable differential equation is there. So I'm just taking that the dv is there, so I'm just taking this one portion on the left hand side, so I have to take the 1 plus v divided by v square, minus is there, dx is on, will be on the right hand side, and x goes to on the denominator on the right hand side. That also you can make this way. I'm just saying that 1 plus v divided by v square into dv is equal minus times dx divided by x. That also you can write. Now you have to do the separate division, and also you can write that the 1 plus y square plus 1 by v dv is equal minus dx by x. Now it is required to integrating on the both the side, and integrating constant is there, so you can take integrating constant is that is it, because all the terms are the logarithm function. So in that case we can have the arbitrary constant can be logarithm function. So here after integrating you will have this one, and after what you are going to take this on the left hand side and minus 1 by v on the right hand side, so it will be the plus, and according to the our property of the logarithm, so we can write ln of vx is equal 1 by v, but 1 can be written as what, that is ln e, and that's why we have written over here. And also we can write the ln e raised to 1 by v plus ln c. Now you can see that ln of e raised to 1 by v plus into c, because of the property of the logarithm function. So now take the exponential on the both the sides, so you will have this one, but already v is replaced by what, by y by x, because we have assumed that y is equal to vx. And therefore, simplifying, you will get this one. So this is what exactly our general solution. So in this video, we have discussed about these two methods, variable separable, and second is the homogeneous differential equation. Thank you.